And after this panel finishes, we'd certainly be happy to give both sides the opportunity. JB's in the back, you can raise his hand if you want to visit with JB after it's over. We've got our cameras in the back, we'd be happy. If you'd like to say, this is why I support issue one, or this is why I oppose issue one, we'd certainly be happy for you all to do that after the event is over. If you want to learn more about issue one, what I recommend from our perspective is you visit our website, yesonone.com. You can find us on Facebook, you can find us on Twitter, you can find our YouTube channel, and you can find a number of people who are advocates for issue one who will talk about why it's important for the state of Arkansas. And what I like to tell people when I travel around the state and I've been to community groups and other organizations is it's time to pass common sense lawsuit reform for Arkansas to help our state grow jobs and to help our state compete for recruit doctors to care for our families. Now, it's no secret that the fight for lawsuit reform that you see today started in 2003 with the Civil Justice Reform Act of 2003. And I suspect many of you all in this room, including Congressman French Hill, were involved in leadership in passing those reforms. Unfortunately, over a series of rulings, the Arkansas Supreme Court gutted the Civil Justice Reform Act of 2003 and said, you can't do this stuff legislatively, you have to pass a constitutional amendment, and that's why we're here today. So let's talk about why it's important for our state. And I'd recommend that you dig deep into the facts of what is exactly in issue one that was impossible for us standing here today or sitting here today to go over all the details. There are tremendous resources for Cooperative Extension Service. You can go on our website. There's tremendous resources out there for folks to look at. And I'll start, I'll quote some subject matter experts in their own words. The first view of Arkansas for Jobs and Justice. We're a broad-based coalition that represent farmers, doctors, hospitals, job creators, large and small, truckers, poultry federation, a number of different organizations. And why is issue one important for growing jobs in Arkansas? Well, let's look at some of our neighboring states. In 2011, the president of the Dallas Federal Reserve Bank was asked on CNBC why 38% of all the jobs in the United States were created in Texas. He said, there's two reasons. And I said, what are they? And in his own words, he said, well, we don't have state income tax. Very important. The president of the Dallas Federal Reserve Bank said the most important reason is because we have poor people. Lieutenant Governor Tim Griffin in Arkansas said this, in November we can make Arkansas a better place to grow jobs and raise our families while we pursue the critical ingredients of tax reform, regulatory reform, education reform. Let's add the much needed ingredient of lawsuit reform. Most of the states in the United States have it. All of the states that surround Arkansas have it. Let's pass issue one and let's give Arkansas a recipe for a prosperous and more healthy Arkansas. In surveys, over 80% of senior executives and corporations around America said the civil justice environment of the state is a key critical factor of deciding where they locate businesses. In Mississippi, the governor, Haley Barber, said he got a letter from Toyota USA. Toyota was looking to locate a plant.
Mr. Danielson, you have an objection to issue one. What